Let us pray. Father, we thank you for your goodness. We thank you for this wonderful program. We thank you, Lord, because you are a faithful God. The time has come for you to speak to us. We prepare our hearts to receive from you. Speak from your throne of grace. For in Jesus' mighty name we pray. Please be seated. The title of the short exhortation is Faithful God. Faithful God. And let me join the Jagedes to welcome you to this 20th wedding anniversary celebration of Evangelist Eunice and Evangelist Mike Jagede. For those of us who know them, we can testify that God is faithful in their lives. I'm sure that they choose the team deliberately. Faithful God. You've heard their testimonies. I don't know which kind of man will go and propose to a woman and say, I don't have anything, but God said I will marry you. It is only the jaggedest of this world that can do that. Amen? But God is faithful. And whatever he says he will do it. God is not a liar. Man cannot be relied upon. But God is always faithful. Despite every challenge that a man may face in life, God is always faithful. The Bible is very clear. In Deuteronomy chapter 7, verse 9, the Bible says, therefore, know that the Lord your God, he is God, the faithful God who keeps covenant and mercy for 1,000 generations with those who love him and keep his commandments. You know, many people always talk about curses that are passed from generation to generation. In fact, the Bible says up to the fourth generation. I always counter it with this verse that says that the mercy of God goes to how many generations? 1,000 generation. But there are many Christians who tend to be Satan-centric instead of God-centric. You know, we are liberated, we are saved, we are being delivered, and we are no longer under the curse of Satan. Amen. Amen. And you can see it from the testimonies, you know. If you know, cats enter the tire of many people, they will not reach where they are going. But as a child of God, you have been liberated, you have been delivered, you are not an ordinary person, you carry Jesus inside of you. So wherever you go, you carry the power of God. Amen? Amen. In Psalm 33 verse 4, the Bible says, Psalm 33 verse 4, for the word of the Lord is right and true. He is faithful in all he does. Our God is faithful. Everything he does is faithful. And I like the passage we read, the scripture reading, Psalm 124. Psalm 124 from verses 1 to 8. From verse 1, it says, if the Lord had not been on our side. I'm sure we can all relate with that statement. Many of us here, if the Lord had not been on your side, you would not be here. Because there are many people who were born the same date with you. In fact, if you look at the primary school picture, class picture of many people, you will be shocked. You cannot but thank God because many of them, they will have written R.I.P. 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 there. But you are alive today, not because of your power, not because of your mind, not because of your righteousness, but because of the grace of God. Like the psalmist said, he said, people have attacked us. Flood have risen against us. There have been raging waters. And he said, we have escaped. We have escaped them. So, our God is faithful in many areas. There are at least seven areas where God is faithful. Number one, God is faithful as a pardoner. God pardons us. He cleanses those who confess and forsake their sins. As we can see in 1 John chapter 1 verse 9. So God is a pardoner. Number two, God is a protector. He protects us. And when it is difficult, he provides a way of escape. Provides a way of escape. Number three, as a provider, God provides for us. He provides for us. Number four, as a promiser, God has promised and is faithful. For the promises of God are what? Yea and amen. Number five, as a purifier, God sanctifies. He sanctifies us and makes us holy. It's not by power. Number six, as a preserver, God preserves us and keeps us from evil. That is the counsel I give everybody every day. I say, before you go out every day, pray that God deliver me from evil. You know, evil can come and meet you in your house. There's a story I told. This one is a life story. A retired military man. He was sleeping in his house in the estate. And by 1 a.m. in the morning, the security man of the compound came and knocked at his door. And you know, soldier, you knock at his door. 1 a.m. he come out, he see you, say, be security man. Where do you go? Do you go open door? Huh? Soldier, true soldier, you don't go open door. Go open the door. So now the soldier come out, he sees the security man, he open door, say, waiting. The security man was drunk. Started abusing the man. And they had a scuffle. He heard the man and called the other security man. Come and carry your foolish man who is drunk. Now they can't carry the man. Take him from there. Go in house. That is the security man's house for the same estate. The following morning when they wake up, the security man don't die. They arrested the man. He has killed somebody. I don't know whether you understand. He was in detention for months for murder. What did he do? He was sleeping in his house. There is a story of a woman who was coming from Mararaba. And he had accident with one other man. They were dragging who was wrong and who was right. And he called his husband, who is in Abuja. Say, see one useless man, no. Now the husband enter moto. Go meet her for there. When the husband reached there, they started the argument. One trailer come. Clear all of them. They all died. So, one thing. Don't go from your house without praying, God, keep me away from trouble. Because when the trouble comes, you know. There's one other one that happened in Mabushide. One man and one woman, they jammed themselves. The woman came down, reached the woman with a crate, slapped the man. The man fell down and died. So, our God is a preserver. I pray we preserve you from every evil. Amen. Our God is a performer. What he has promised, he will perform. And my prayer is that even for the remaining part of the year, what God has promised for you, he will perform it in Jesus' name. Amen. You know, as Evangelist said, last month we celebrated our 30th wedding anniversary. And we celebrated it with about 17 people we have wedded in the course of ministry. And we shared with them three things. which I want to share with you as we close. 3 C's of blissful marriage: commitment, communication, and compromise. First is commitment. The beginning point in a blissful marriage is that both partners should be true believers and practicing Christians. Whenever there is a problem in marriage, one or both parties have fallen short of the standard of God. So couples should be committed to each other. And this commitment, not from one side. The two of them must be committed. Couples should be committed and they should be faithful to one another. Number two is communication. Communication. Communication is probably the most important issue in marriage. Couples must learn to communicate with each other following biblical principles of communicating truth in love, controlling what we say, not speaking evil, speaking with wisdom, and speaking gentle words. You know, during one of our couples night, I was sharing it during the message this morning. Somebody stood up. He said, look, he doesn't know how the women of these days behave. That when he was growing up, he saw the father. When the father is anointed, he will shout for the wife. And the wife will kneel down and be begging. Say, but when he's shouting for the wife, the wife will stand and be looking her in the face. And they will be answering him. So I now ask him, I say, okay. Does your wife shout at you? And the guy was confused. Say, shout? What does the Bible say? He said, do unto others what you want them to do what? So communication, speak to your spouse how you want your spouse to do what? Speak unto you. When you follow that principle, there will be peace and blissful marriage. And finally, compromise. Couples should practice mutual submission. I have attended many marriage ceremonies. Most of the pastors start preaching from Ephesians chapter 5, verse 22. Wives, submit to your husbands. I'm encouraging everyone, especially as there are pastors here, always start from 21. Submit to one another in the fear of the Lord. You know, one of the greatest problems in this world is to take a verse from the Bible and elevate it into a doctrine. Or you see one problem in the world and you elevate it. You see, because there is problem in social media, you say social media is evil. Where you can use social media to preach the word. I pray that all of us will be able to practice mutual submission in Jesus' name. Amen. Do not insist on your right. Compromise is required to adjust to differences in behavior. Sleeping with or without light, that can cause trouble. If one person is sleeping with light and the other one says, I don't sleep with light. If you don't settle it well, the one who sleeps with light, if you put off the light, he will not sleep. And the following morning will be irritable. Or squeezing toothpaste from the middle or from the... He said, why are you going to squeeze me from middle as if you'll be small pikin? If they squeeze the thing from middle, squeeze them. What is the difference? That is not sufficient to bring quarrel. But for many couples, it's those small, small things. Splashing of water on the floor in the bedroom. You don't know, man. He said, where are you? You see the bedroom, water full everywhere. Or you go urinate. You didn't remove the... What do you call that thing? The sitter. The seat cover. Those, he get many people. When they quarrel, if you ask them, what is the cause of the quarrel? They won't be see. Is this small, small things? So just compromise. Compromise. Dressing of the bed. If you are a man, if you dress bed, they know you cut your hand, come out. Little, little things that can make the marriage work. Compromise is required in relationship with in-laws and others. Always be on the same page. Each person should handle their problematic relations. Hello? You know their problematic relations. They can have problematic mother-in-laws, father-in-laws, brother-in-laws. If you are the one who has a problematic one, you know. The other party should just stay aside and let you deal with your mother if your mother is the problematic one. Deal with your father if your father is the problematic one. But compromise is required. Compromise is required in handling money. Hello? There must be budget. But it's not that the budget is made for man, not man for budget. It's not that because there is budget, you say you won't do 20th anniversary celebration. I didn't teach that one. No? You know, I celebrate well. I celebrate my own. But there should be the budget. You know? Do not be stingy and do not be greedy. Also, do not be a spendthrift. Because if you spend all your money, you end up in poverty. Unless you inherit wealth. If you don't inherit wealth, the only way to become rich is to save and invest. So, these are the three ways by which you can make your marriage blissful. In conclusion, my dear brothers and sisters, our God is faithful. He does not change. Jesus is the same yesterday, today, and forever. As we celebrate today, God has been faithful to the Jegedes in 20 years. God has protected them. Testimonies abound on the goodness of God to them. As we celebrate, we are trusting God to meet them at the point of their knees in Jesus' name. Amen. Faithful, you are faithful. King of kings, Lord of lords, you are faithful. Faithful, you are faithful. King of kings, Lord of lords, I worship you. Our Father and our Lord, we thank you, we honor you. We glorify your holy name. We thank you, Lord, because you are a faithful God. We thank you for the faithfulness you have displayed for the Jegedes in the past 20 years. Our Father and our God, we thank you for everyone that has come here to celebrate with them. We ask, Lord, that you will extend your faithfulness to everyone here in the name of Jesus. In particular, Lord, we pray that for the Jegedes and everyone who is here to celebrate with them today, you will meet each and everyone at the point of their needs. Amen. As we plan to enter 2024, we will all enter 2024 in a glorious manner. Amen. And you will meet everyone at the points of their needs. Amen. Thank you, Lord, for answered prayers. In Jesus' mighty name, we pray. Amen.